the refraction through the prism, then scattering of light, then the rainbows. So I would like to told you people that in this current session, CBSE has eliminated some topics like human eye and defects of vision. If we talk about dispersion of light, then dispersion through the prism, deviation, dispersive power, angular dispersion expression, they also have been eliminated. So don't bother about these type of topics as they are eliminated by CBSE. So today we people are going to study about the last sub-chapter of this ray optics chapter, what we call human eye and optical instruments. So human eye and defects of vision, as I already told you that these topics has been eliminated. So we people are going to study only about the optical instruments, in which the first topic is about the simple microscope. The CBSE asked the question upon this topic, like what do you mean by simple microscope, Dryden expression for its magnifying power, or angular magnification, when the image is formed at the least distance of distinct vision, and when the image is formed at infinity. So let us study about this simple microscope in detail. Simple microscope. So how we can define this? Simple microscope is basically a convex lens of short focal length that is used to see the magnified image of the object. That is what we call simple microscope. So we can define it. A convex lens of short focal length used to see the magnified image of the object is called as simple microscope. Okay, now what about its principle? It is based upon the principle that whenever an object is placed between the optical center and the principal focus of convex lens, a virtual erect large magnified image is formed on the same side of the object. Let's study about this. We can say it is based upon the principle that when an object is placed between the optical center and principal focus of the convex lens, it produces virtual erect and magnified image and magnified image of the magnified image of on the same side of the object, image on the same side, on the same side of object. So this is the principle of simple microscope. Now we people are going to derive the expression for its magnifying power, also called as angular magnification. In case one, when the image is formed at the least distance of distinct vision. So let's derive the expression for the magnifying power. Magnifying power, or another name is angular magnification. Angular magnification. Magnification. Angular magnification. First case, we people are going to study when the image is formed at, when the image is formed at, when the image is formed at least distance of distinct vision, least distance of distinct vision. So how we can derive this expression for magnifying power? We will draw a diagram first of all. So what about diagram? Consider a convex lens of short focal length. Convex lens of short focal length in this way. Let us consider an object. This is the optical center. Let us consider this is the principal focus. An object AB is placed just between this optical center and principal focus of this lens. So this is the first principal focus. Since the lens has the two principal focus, so let us consider this is the second principal focus. Now what would happen? A ray of light traveling parallel to the principal axis, after suffering refraction will pass through the second principal focus. Another ray of light passing through the optical center will go unrefracted as shown in the figure. And the first ray of light which goes like that after a refraction. So what we can say about here, that is both the rays are diverging in different direction after refraction. In this way, these both the rays are diverging in different directions. So in order to produce the image, we will reproduce them in the backward direction. So if we reproduce these rays of light in the backward direction, then what would happen? At a point where these two rays intersect each other, the final image, that is what we call A dash B dash, is formed. A dash B dash is formed, and this image is formed at the least distance of distinct vision. That is denoted by capital D. Okay, so here we can denote it by D. Then this is the object distance. So object distance is denoted by U, like that. Okay. Now some consideration part is there. What about the consideration part? Here is the eye of the observer. So in consideration part, what we have to consider the angles subtended at the eye by the image and by the object. So let us consider the angle subtended at the eye by the image is denoted by beta, and this angle is C, what we can say, A dash C B dash. Let us consider this angle as beta. is the angle subtended by the image at the eye. Okay. Now, we will do some construction. Well, the cut AQ equivalent to AB, and then join QC. Then joining QC, what we got? Then joining QC, what we got? The let A dash CQ is equals to angle alpha is the angle subtended by the object. So here we people are considering these angles. Let angle C A dash B dash is equals to beta is the angle subtended by the image at I and another angle, that is not C A dash B dash, instead we will write A dash C B dash, A dash C this B dash, this is the angle, and another angle A dash C Q, A dash C Q is equals to the alpha, and alpha is the angle subtended by the object at I when seen directly. So in this way we have considered these angles. Further, here we have done the constructions. Let A dash Q is equals to AB. So here we can write here we can do the construction, that is cut A dash Q is equals to AB, that is equals to object AB equals to this. Now let's drive the expression for its magnifying power. First of all, we will define this magnifying power and angle, or what we say, angular magnification. Now, as we know that, we can define this magnifying power or angular magnification, it is denoted by capital M and is given by, it is defined as the ratio of the angle subtended by the image, ratio of the angle subtended by the image, that is this beta angle, to the angle subtended by the object when both lies at the least distance of distinct vision. Both lies means, here we have considered the construction that cut A dash Q is equal to AB, means to say we have taken this object here because of this, both the angles cannot be similar, na? So that's why we have considered here alpha is different angle. So in order to consider this, when we see it directly, then this object may lie here. Okay, so here magnifying power, first of all I am defining it. How we can define this magnifying power? It is defined as the ratio of the angle subtended by the image at I to the angle subtended by object when seen directly, or simply we can say by object seen directly. Object seen directly. When both lies at the least distance of distinct vision. Both lies at least distance of distinct vision. Distinct vision. That is what we call D, and least distance or distinct vision for the eye is equals to 25 centimeter. Okay. So in this way, we people have defined this magnifying power. Once again, I'm repeating, defined as the ratio of the angle subtended by the image to the angle subtended by the object seen directly when both lies at the least distance of distinct vision. That is capital M is equals to beta by alpha. Now, these angles beta and alpha, these angles beta is the angle subtended by the image and alpha is the angle subtended by the object, as both are lying at the least distance of distinct vision. So this beta is the angle subtended by the image and alpha angle subtended by the object. These angles are so small so that they can be replaced by their tangents. So here we can say that as angles beta and alpha are small so that they can be replaced by their tangents. So that they can be replaced by their tangents. So what we get in the next step? So therefore, magnifying power or angular magnification will become equals to tan beta over tan alpha. Let it be equation number one. Now we would like to put the value of tan beta and tan alpha. What about tan beta? For tan beta, we people will consider this triangle CAB, right angle triangle CAB, because tan beta is made by this ray of light. So CAB, this triangle will be taken for beta, tan beta, and for tan alpha we will consider the triangle, that is we will consider the triangle CA dash Q. So here I am writing in triangle CAB, what we have the tangent of angle beta is equals to CAB, tangent beta is equals to AB over CA, tangent of angle beta, that is AB over CA in this way. Further, in triangle for tan alpha, which triangle we have considered? CA dash Q. In triangle CA dash Q, what we have? Tangent of angle alpha is equals to tan alpha A dash Q over CA dash. A dash Q over CA dash. CA dash. Now here, but A dash Q is equivalent to, what about A dash Q? A dash Q is equivalent to AB. So we will put its value here. Therefore, tan alpha will we get AB over CA dash. Let this in this way we got the tan alpha and tan beta. Now we will put these values in equation number one. So what we get? What we get in the next step? This distance was D, this distance was the object distance, that is U. Okay, so now we people will put, therefore, from equation 1, what we get? M is equals to tan beta. What about tan beta? Tan beta, here we will put AB over CA. So I am putting its value AB over CA divided by tan alpha, that is AB over CA dash, and that is equals to AB over CA into CA dash over AB. Now AB and AB will get cancelled out. What we get? M is equals to CA dash over C. CA. Let this be equation number 2. Okay. Now we will apply the new partition sign conventions. But CA dash is equals to, CA dash is the image distance denoted by this minus D, is equals to minus D. What about CA? CA is the, what we can say, CA is equals to U and is measured against the incident ray, so it should be taken as negative, so CA is equals to minus U. So therefore from equation 2, therefore equation 2 will become, M is equals to minus D by minus U, that is equals to M is equals to D by U. So this is the required expression for the magnifying power or angular magnification produced by the this convex lens or short focal lens when the object is placed between C and F. Once again I am repeating, we studied about simple microscope. What is simple microscope? A convex lens or short focal lens used to see the magnified images of the object is called as simple microscope. What is the principle of this? When an object is placed between the optical center and the principal focus of convex lens, this AB, it produces virtual enlarged magnified image of the object on the same side of the object in this way. Okay, after that we people have drawn this diagram. So in diagram what we have considered, a ray of light going parallel to principal axis, after suffering refraction it passes through the second principal focus, another ray of light passing through the optical center goes unrefracted into rarer medium. As both the rays are diverging in different directions, so in order to produce the image we have reproduced them in the backward direction, and these rays, let us consider they intersect at point of B dash. So this A dash and B dash will be the final image. Okay, now we have considered the angles. What about the angle subtended by the image? What about the angle subtended by the object? So here in this case, first of all we have done the construction that cut A dash Q, A dash Q equivalent to AB. Then we considered the angles. First of all, let us consider this angle ACB is equals to beta be the angle subtended by the image, angle subtended by the image which is lying at the least distance or distinct region at the eye. And for the object, if we take this as object, then beta and alpha will be same, then we cannot derive the expression. So what we have done, we have just considered that, let us consider AB is lying here and this A dash Q is such that equivalent to AB. So this angle is alpha, A dash CQ. We have considered the angle alpha is the angle subtended by the object, when seen directly at the eye. Okay, and then we have defined this magnifying power or the angular magnification. It is defined as the ratio of the angle subtended by the image at the eye to the angle subtended by the object seen directly when both lies at the least distance of distinct vision. Now as this is denoted by capital M, M will be equal to beta by alpha. In the next step we have defined that as these angles are so small so that they can be replaced by their tangents. So this M is equal to beta by alpha, we can write M is equal to tan beta by tan alpha. Let this be equation number 1. Now we want to put the values of tan beta and tan alpha. But about tan beta, for tan beta we have considered the right angle triangle CAB. In CAB what we have, the tan beta AB over CA. And in triangle CA dash Q, EQ, what we have tan alpha here in this case, tan alpha is equals to A dash Q over CA dash. Substituting the value in equation 1, what we get, M is equals to CA dash over CA. Now what about CA dash? CA dash is equals to D and is measured against the incident ray. So it is taken to be negative, that is minus U. And what about CA? CA is equals to U and is again measured in the direction opposite to the incident ray. So according to sign convention, it should be taken as a negative. So therefore from equation 2 what we get, M is equals to D by U. So this is the required derivation. Now we can further express this magnifying power by using the Lenz equation. If we introduce the Lenz equation, then how this formula will become for the magnifying power? Let us study about it. Further, if I write further as, we know that from the Lenz equation minus 1 by u plus 1 by v is equals to 1 by f in this way. So here in this diagram, if we look at the diagram, then u, that is object distance is this, that is equals to minus u, and what about v? That is the image formed is lying at the least distance of distinct vision. Then what we get here, u is equals to minus u and v is lying at minus d, v is equals to minus d. Then what we get if we put the values, so therefore 1 over u minus 1 over d will be equals to 1 by f in this way. Now if we multiply this equation on both sides by capital D, that is least distance or distinct vision, how this equation becomes? Multiplying both sides, the above equation by capital D. So what we get? D by u minus d by d, that is equal to 1, will be equals to d by f in this way. Or we can write, which implies d by u is equal to 1 plus d by f in this way. D by u is equals to 1 plus d by f. Now here, what about d by u? What about d by u is equals to magnifying power? So here we can write, but this d by u is equals to capital M. So in this way, we can express this magnifying power relation by using the Lenz equation. When the image is formed at the least distance of distinct vision, this is another form, another formula. M is equals to D by F. Mind that this capital D, it is the least distance of distinct vision, and for the normal it is found to be 25 cm. Again I am repeating, this distance is 25 cm. Okay, this is the required derivation for the magnifying power or angular magnification. The case was when the image is found at the least distance of distinct vision. Now let's study about the second case. When the image is found at infinity, then how we can derive the expression for this magnifying power? Let's study about that. On the same way, we will derive this expression. In simple microscope, we people are going to derive the expression for the magnifying power when the image is found at infinity. Simple microscope, the expression for magnifying power, we people are going to derive magnifying power. The case is when the image is formed at infinity. When image is formed at infinity. Formed at infinity. Okay. Let's study about this case. First of all, we people draw the diagram. This is the convex lens of short focal length. Let us consider this C is the optical center. Here F is the first principal focus and here F is the second principal focus. Now here, if we place the object AB, let us consider the object is placed at the principal focus, then what could happen? A ray of light is traveling to the parallel axis, traveling parallel to the principal axis. Another ray of light will fall on the optical center. Now what would happen after refraction? The ray of light traveling parallel to the principal axis, it passes through the principal focus of the lens. Another ray of light passing through the optical center of the lens goes unrefracted. So if the observer is lying here, then for an observer, these rays of light will appear to be coming from infinity in this way. These rays of light will appear to be coming from infinity. Okay? So, this is the diagram. Now, we people will consider the angle subtended by the image, angle subtended by the object. First of all, we people are doing the construction here. Cut this a dash q equal to AB perpendicular to principal axis. So here we have taken, let a dash q is perpendicular to principal axis such that a dash q is equal to a. Now join this q and c. We have joined q and c. Then join q, c. Okay. Now we will consider the angle subtended by the image and angle subtended by the object. So let us consider this ACB is equals to beta, be the angle subtended by the image lying at infinity, and this A dash CQ is equals to alpha, be the angle subtended by the object. Okay, and here in this case the object is lying at the least distance of distinct vision. So here we will denote this CA dash by D and this by U, and U is equals to F, that is the focal length of this lens. Okay. Now in this case we people are going to consider the angles. So here let angle ACB is equals to beta be the angle subtended by image lying at infinity and angle, another angle we have considered, that a dash cq is equals to alpha, be the angle subtended subtended by object, object, object lying at the least distance of a distinct vision. Okay. Now, we people define this magnifying power. Now, as we know that M is equals to beta by alpha. We have already defined this magnifying power. Now here in this case, how we will define magnifying power is defined as the ratio of the angle subtended by the image situated at infinity to the angle subtended by the object lying at the least distance of a distinct vision. Once again repeating, the magnifying power or the angular magnification is defined as the ratio of angle subtended by the image situated at infinity to the angle subtended by the object lying at the least distance of distinct vision. That is, M is equals to beta by alpha. Since the angle beta and alpha are so small, so that they can be replaced by their tangents, then which implies, so we can say here, as angles beta and alpha are so small, so that they can be replaced by their tangents, then what we get, so therefore M can be written as tan beta over tan alpha, like that. Now what about tan beta? For tan beta we will consider the right angle triangle CAB, and for tan alpha we will consider the right angle triangle CA dash Q. Okay. So let it be question number 1. Now I will write here in triangle CAB. What we have? Tan beta is equals to AB over CA. Okay. And in triangle inter for tan alpha CA dash Q, we have tan alpha is equals to A dash Q over CA dash in this way. So therefore from equation 1, what we get, M will becomes equals to AB over CA divided by tan alpha, that is A dash Q over CA dash. Now here one thing we have missed here, but A dash Q we have considered it as equals to AB. So here tan alpha can rewritten as AB over CA dash. Why? Because A dash Q we have considered is equivalent to AB. So here instead of this A dash Q, we will write here it is equals to AB. So what we get in the next step, which implies M is equals to AB over CA is equals to CA dash over AB. Now AB and AB, they both will get cancelled out. So what we get, M is equals to CA dash over CA according to new Cartesian sign conventions. Now what about this CA and what about this CA dash? So here substituting the value, now we have the CA is equals to U and U is equals to F. Okay, and what about this CA dash is equals to D, and since both the distance are measured in the direction opposite to the incident ray, so they should be taken as negative, that is equals to minus F we can write, and CA dash is equals to minus D. So therefore we got the required formula, that is therefore M is equals to D by F. So this is the required formula or expression for the magnifying power. in case of simple microscope when the image is found at a infinity. So here we people have studied the two cases. In case one, when the image was formed at the least distance of distinct vision, and here in the second case, when the image is formed at a infinity. So mind that in the earlier case, the formula was m is equals to 1 plus d by f, where d was the least distance of distinct vision, and here in this case, m is equals to d by f. What the conclusion we people are drawing from these formulas? In both the formulas, if we look at about these formulas, in case of simple microscope, in both the cases, in the first case we have derived the formula m is equals to 1 plus d by f, and in the second case m is equals to simply d by f. The magnifying power of the simple microscope is inversely proportional to focal length of the lens. If focal length is small, then magnifying power will be large. So this point should be kept in mind in future, that we have to make use of the simple microscope, the convex lens of shorter and shorter focal length, and it will produce the greater magnification. Okay. So students, this is all about the simple microscope. Next topic is compound microscope. Now, why we need the compound microscope? We have already available for the simple microscope. Mind that. Simple microscope in the practical life, if we discuss about this type of microscope, it is used by the, what we can say, as a magnifying glass. Further, it is used in the laboratories in order to see the vernier scales. The condition is object should lie between the optical center and the principal focus of convex lens of a short focal length. Only under that condition we can see the magnified image of the object. So in the labs it is used, it is also used by the watch mechanics. They often wear the simple microscope in their eyes in order to correct the minute defects in the watches. So in this way, these are some of the uses. Mind that magnifying power is inversely proportional to focal length. Okay. Now, let's study about the second topic, that is what we call compound microscope. And on the basis of this topic, so many times CBSE has asked the question carrying 5 marks. What about compound microscope? Why we need this? Compound microscope is basically an instrument which is used to see the magnified images of extremely small objects. Like if we want to see the cell wall of the onion, then under the slide we can, by making use of this instrument, we can see the magnified image of that particular cell wall which is visible to us. Normally we are not able to see that type of cell wall of the onion. In the same way, we can say the red blood cells, RBCs, WBCs, with the help of this compound microscope. So let us study about this. What is compound microscope? What about its principle? What about its construction? What about its working? So CBSE asked this question carrying a 5 marks. So let us study about this. What about this compound microscope? Compound microscope. How we can define it? Simply, a device which is used to see the magnified images of extremely small objects. A device which is used to see the magnified images, used to see the magnified images of extremely small objects. Extremely small objects is called as compound microscope. Now, what about its construction? What about the construction of this compound microscope? So if we talk about the construction, compound microscope consists of two lenses, a lens facing the, or simply we can say two lens system facing the object is called as object lens. It has a short focal length and short aperture. The lens system facing the eye is called as eye lens. It has large aperture but has a short focal length. So let's study about this construction. In construction we can say compound microscope consists of two lenses. The lens facing the object is called as object lens. It has short aperture and short focal length. It has short aperture and short focal length. The another lens facing the eye is called as eye lens. The other lens facing the eye is called as eye lens. It has large aperture and short focal length. Mind that both the lenses, whether the object lens and whether the eye lens, they both have the short focal length. Here the eye lens have the short aperture but the eye lens has the large aperture. This thing should be kept in mind. Okay, both the lens are fitted at the end of a tube, and the distance between them can be adjusted with the help of rack and pinion arrangement. Rack and pinion arrangement means one lens is fitted here, one lens is fitted here. So they both are fitted in the coaxial tubes like that. So here if we hold a screw, then the distance between both these lenses can be adjusted. Okay, so here I am writing, that is, both the lenses are fitted at the end of the tube, and in order to focus over an object, the distance between object and eye lens can be adjusted with the help of rack and pinion arrangement. rack and pinion arrangement. Now the question arises that what is this rack and pinion arrangement? Suppose we have this long tube, one lens is fitted here and the other lens is fitted here like that, in this way, and these both the lenses are fitted coaxially in a long tube. So here we have a screw like that, in this way. If we rotate this screw, then distance between this lens and this lens can be adjusted, can be increased or decreased. So this arrangement is called as rack and pinion arrangement. Okay, so this is students about the construction. Now we people are going to study about its principle. What about its principle? Then we will drive that question for the magnifying power, because this question is asked in the annual exam carrying 5 marks, so that's why we are writing this theoretical part simultaneously. Now what about the principle of this compound microscope? If we talk about this principle, so the principle says, when an object is placed just beyond the principal focus of object lens, then it's real, an inverted image is formed on the other side of object lens beyond 2f. Now this image formed by the object lens will act as object for the eyes. Further, the image formed by object lens acts as object for eye lens. Now the distance between object and eye lens is adjusted in such a way such that the final image is formed at the least distance of distinct vision, or it is formed at infinity. Then the distance between object lens and eye lens is adjusted with the help of rack and pinion arrangement, with the help of rack and pinion arrangement, such that the final image is formed at least distance of distinct vision, or at infinity. So this is the principle of this compound microscope. Now let's write the expression for the magnifying power. When the image is formed at the least distance of distinct vision, in the second case when the image is formed at infinity. Okay, so this is clear to all of you. Again I am repeating, compound microscope, a device which is used to see the magnified images of extremely small objects is known as compound microscope. In construction, compound microscope basically consists of two lens systems or simply two lenses. We say instead two lenses, we can say lens systems is the appropriate word, lens system. Compound microscope consists of two lens systems. The lenses facing or simply lens system facing the object is called as object lens. It has short aperture and short focal length. The other lens facing the or other lens system, simply we can say here the system. Other lens system facing the eyes is called as eye lens, or simply eyepiece. Sometimes it is called as eyepiece. It has large aperture and but short focal length. The similarity between these two lenses is they both have the short focal length. Mind that. Both the lenses are fitted at the end of the tube, and in order to focus over an object, the distance between object and the eye lens can be adjusted with the help of rack and pinion arrangement. Okay. What about the principle? When an object is placed just beyond the principal focus of object lens, then its real and inverted image is formed on the other side of the object lens beyond 2f0. Further, the image formed by this object lens acts as an object for the eye lens, and the distance between object and the eye lens is adjusted with the help of rack and pinion arrangement, such that the final image is formed at the least distance of distinct vision or at infinity. So in this way, we studied about its principle. Now let's derive the expression for its magnifying power. Okay. So we people are going to derive the expression for its magnifying power. First of all, we people will draw the diagram. The case we people are going to study here, that is, we are going to derive the expression for magnifying power. The case is when the image is formed at least distance of distinct vision. I am writing here capital D. Okay. So for this, first of all, we people will draw the diagram. So the diagram is little bit complicated. You have to practice it two or three times or simultaneously. You can practice with me. First of all, we will draw this line, what we call principal X. Here, this is our object lens. It is of short aperture and having the short focal length. Let us consider this is f0. We are writing it as object length. Short focal length and short aperture, denoted by f0. This is the optical center of this object lens. Now, what would happen? This is the second principal focus. We can write it as f0. Here, 2f0. Now, an object is placed. Object AB is placed just beyond the principal focus of object lens. Just beyond the principal focus of this object lens. I am writing, but like that. Okay. So what would happen? A ray of light traveling parallel to the principal axis. Another ray of light falling on the optical center of this object lens. What would happen after refraction? That ray of light traveling parallel to the principal axis will pass through the principal focus of the object lens, like as in this way. Another ray of light falling through the optical center, it will go unrefracted like that. It will go unrefracted, and at a point where these two rays meet, the final magnified real image is formed. So magnified image formed by real inverted magnified image, that is A dash B dash, is formed by the object lens. This is, and this image is formed beyond 2f naught. Now this image formed by the object lens will act as object for the eye lens. So here in this case, if we talk about this what we say eye lens, so here we have the eye lens, and eye lens, as I have already stated, it has a large aperture but is of short focal length in this way, and its optical center is, let us consider, denoted by C dash, and here this distance is denoted by FE like that. Okay, so now this A dash B dash, since it is lying in between optical center and the principal focus of this what we call eye lens or eyepiece, so the image formed by this eye lens will be virtual, erect and magnified on the side of the object, as we have earlier studied about it. So how the image will be produced by it? So for producing the image, first of all, here we will locate the position of the image like this, and this we can got the idea of how much long it should be. You can draw a ray of light passing through the optical center of this lens such that it goes unrefracted according to rule. So if we reproduce it in the backward direction, so we people got the idea that where should the image should be, and the second ray you can also plot this as like as. So if this is the, this distance is the, it is the, what we can say, focal, principal focus of this eye lens, then here I am also getting the idea that this ray of light after suffering refraction should goes like that, and it should goes like that. So for an observer here, the rays of light are diverging, so both the rays should be reproduced in the backward direction such that we got this final image at a point where all these both the rays after suffering refraction they meet each other like that. Let us consider they meet each other at point, we call it as A double dash and B double dash in this way, because both the rays are diverging here. So in order to produce the final image, we have reproduced them in the backward direction in this way. So at a point where these two rays intersect each other, the final virtual, simply for this lens, virtual magnified erect image is found on the same side of the object. Okay, now here in this case I am saying here virtual simply for this eye lens, because this the image is real, so real image we are getting, but for this lens, as the object is lying between F, its principal focus and optical center, so it will produce the virtual image. So if the object is real, then it will produce the real image, that's why, means to say. Now the construction is there, cut A double dash Q, A double dash Q equals to AB, okay, and join QC dash. Here we people are joining this QC dash in this way. Then we will consider the angles. Let us consider this A double dash C B double dash. It is the angle subtended by the image at the eye. So this angle is denoted by beta, and this A double dash Q is equivalent to AB. So
this angle subtended by the object is called as alpha. Okay. Now here we have considered that as the image is lying at the least distance of distinct vision, so I denote it as capital D. This is the object distance, so object distance is denoted by u naught. What about the image distance? Image formed by this object lens is c a dash. So I will write this distance c a dash is equals to c a dash is equal to this. What we will say? This is v naught. Okay. Now this image formed by the object lens is acting as object for the eye lens. So this is basically denoted by object distance for eye lens. So I am denoting it as u e. Okay. Further, this f e and this is basically the focal length of this eye lens. That is f e, like that. So this completes our diagram. And you have to practice it a lot. Sometimes only this diagram is asked for the question carrying 3 marks. It carries the weightage of 3 marks. Only you have to draw this diagram, but not easy. You have to practice it 2 to 3 times. Then only you people will be able to draw this. Now we want to write the expression for the magnifying power. The case is when the image is formed at the least distance of distinct vision. So here, first of all, we have to define the magnifying power. How we can define this magnifying power? In the similar way, earlier we have defined it. That is, okay. Let's define first of all the magnifying power. Magnifying power. So I am writing here, it is defined as, in the annual exam you have to write this statement first of all, it is defined as the ratio of the angle subtended by the image to the angle subtended by the object when both lie at the least distance of distinct vision. Once again I am repeating, it is defined as the ratio of the angle subtended by the image and the eye when seen through the eye lens to the angle subtended by the object, angle subtended by the object when seen directly when both lies at the least distance of distinct vision. Last time, one more time. It is defined as the ratio of the angle subtended by the image simply to the angle subtended by the object when both lies at the least distance of distinct vision. Okay, so magnifying power here we can denote it by m, and m is equals to, what about m here? M is equals to, denoted by m is equals to beta by alpha. Again, we will write as these angles beta and alpha small. Why they are small? Because the eye lens is of short focal length. So we can replace these angles by their tangents. So I am writing here, that is m is equals to tan beta by tan alpha, like that. Let it be question number 1. Now in order to find this value of tan beta, what we will consider here? We are going to consider here right angle triangles A double dash, C dash and B double dash. Once again I am repeating, because this beta angle is contained in this triangle, right angle triangle. So in triangles A double dash, C dash, B double dash, we have tangent of angle beta. So here I am writing, in right angle triangle C dash, A double dash, B double dash, we have tangent of angle beta is equals to, tan beta is equals to A double dash, B double dash over C dash, A double dash. Further, in triangle for tan alpha, we are going to consider the triangle C dash, A double dash, Q. In triangle C dash, A double dash, Q, what we have? Tangent of angle alpha is equals to, A double dash Q over C dash A double dash. Now, but we have considered this A double dash Q. What about A double dash Q? That is equals to AB. So we can write here that is AB over C dash A double dash in this way. Because we have considered here that is A double dash Q is equals to AB in this way. Okay. So in the next step, we will write therefore from equation 1, what we get? What we get? That is M is equals to tan beta A double dash B double dash over dash A double dash divided by tan alpha. What about tan alpha? This is our tan alpha, that is AB over C dash A double dash. So what we get in the next step, that is A double dash B double dash over C dash A double dash multiplied by C dash A double dash over AB. So what we get, this and this, they both will get cancelled out and we get A double dash B double dash over AB. This is the magnifying power. Now we want to express this magnifying power in the combination of lens. Already we have studied this topic, and there we have studied that magnification produced by the combination of the lens is equal to the product of the magnification produced by one lens and the second lens. So in order to express this net magnification produced by object lens and eye lens, what we will do, we will multiply and divide this equation number 2 by A dash and B dash. So what we get in the next step, here I am writing multiplying and dividing equation 2 by A dash B dash. What we get M is equals to A double dash B double dash over AB multiplied by A dash B dash over A dash B dash. So what we get in the next step, so which is equals to A dash B dash over AB, and this will be the ratio of the size of the image to the size of object for the object lens, and it will be equals to M naught, and then A double dash, that is ratio of the size of the image to the A dash B dash size of the object. Mind that this A double dash B double dash size of the image, and here size of the object for eye lens, that is the magnification produced by the eye lens. So we can say M will be equals to M naught into ME, where M naught is the magnification produced by the object lens and ME is the magnification produced by the eye lens. Let it be equation number 3. Now to find M naught, what about M naught? M naught in terms of distance we can denote. M naught is the magnification produced by object lens and it is denoted by this V naught. What about V naught over U naught? Now here I am writing as M naught is equals to V naught over U naught. Now U naught is basically object distance and it is measured against the incident rate, so we will take it as negative. So mind that it is taken to be negative. Let this be question number 4. Now to find ME, that is the magnification produced by the eye lens. Earlier we have studied in case of simple microscope when the object is lying between C dash, that is optical center and focus of the lens, then it has produced the virtual magnified direct image. So there the formula was M is equals to 1 plus B over FE. So directly we can use or we can derive this formula. In the next step we people will write to find ME. What we will do, both as the length equation for the eye lens is minus 1 by UE plus 1 by VE is equals to 1 by FE. So here in this case, this UE is a negative and this VE is also negative. So here I am putting the value, that is UE is equals to minus of this UE, okay, for the what we can say, I am writing the directly the Lenz equation. So here we can say U is equal to minus UE, V is equals to minus D, and F is equal to F, because I length, the focal length is supposed to be positive, convex length is there. So therefore 1 over U minus 1 over D will be equal to 1 by F. Now multiplying this equation both sides by what we can say D, what we get, multiplying both sides above equation, multiplying both sides of above equation by D, capital D. So what we get, that is D by U minus 1 is equals to 1 over this FE, or we can say D by U is equals to 1 plus, simply this will be equals to D by FE. So which implies D by U will be equal to 1 plus D by FE. Okay, so here now we can write here, let's write here the rest of the derivation. Now what would happen here, I am writing it, so therefore which implies D by U, it will becomes equals to 1 plus D by FE. It will becomes equals to 1 plus D by FE. Now this D by U is nothing but magnification produced by the island, that is 1 plus D by FE. Let it be equation number 5. Okay, now we will put the values of this equation 4 and equation 5 in equation number 3. So now using equation 4 and 5, equation 4 and 5 in equation 3, what we get, the net magnification produced by the compound microscope is equal to product of magnification produced by this object lens and eye lens. So substituting the value here, what we get, minus of V naught by U naught into 1 plus D by FE. In this way, this is the required expression for the magnification produced by the compound microscope when the image is lined at the least distance of a distinct vision. We can further elaborate this formula, that is, if we consider that this U naught is approximately equals to F naught, and then what would happen, the image formed by this object lens will lie very close to this eye lens, and eye lens, since it is of short focal length, so this V naught distance will be approximately equals to the length of the tube in which the two lens systems are fitted. So here we can further elaborate, if U naught, that is object distance, is approximately equals to F naught, then V naught will be approximately equals to L, and where L is the length of the tube in which these two lens systems are fitted. So therefore, the net magnification produced compound microscope will be given by minus L by F naught into 1 plus D by FE. In this way, this is the required derivation for the compound magnifying power produced by the compound microscope when the image is found at the least distance of distinct vision. Okay. Once again, repeating, magnifying power, we have defined it, defined as the ratio of the angle subtended by the image to the angle subtended by the object when both lies at the least distance of distinct vision. So M is equals to beta by alpha, as the eye length is of short focal length. So what would happen? These angles will be small so that they can be replaced by their tangents. Then, in order to write the value of this tan beta and tan alpha, we have considered the triangle for tan beta A double dash, B double dash, C or C dash, A double dash, B double dash. This right angle triangle. And in order to write the value of this tan alpha, we consider the triangle, right angle triangle C dash, A double dash, Q. So, taking their values, putting in equation 1, we got this equation number 2. So here we want to express this magnification in terms of product of magnification, because when two lenses are combined, then their net magnification is the product of magnification produced by the individual lens. So M is equals to M0 into ME. If we want to write like that, then we have to multiply and divide this equation by A dash B dash. So we have multiplied and divided this equation 2 by A dash B dash. So what we get? What we get? A double dash B double dash over AB multiplied and dividing by this. Rearranging this equation, what we get? A dash B dash over AB. I have taken this AB here in the denominator of A dash B dash, such that this whole term becomes equals to M naught. This whole term becomes equals to M naught, that is magnification produced by object length. And A double dash B double dash over A dash B dash, it becomes equal to magnification produced by the eye lens. Let this be equation number 3. Now, as we already know that magnification produced by the object lens is equals to V naught by U naught, like that. And since U naught is measured against the direction of incident ray, it should be taken as a negative. Now, to find the value of this ME, we have made use of the lens equation. And we have put the value of this u is equals to minus of ue. Why? Because this object, this is the image produced by object lens, is acting as object for eye lens, and this distance, this ue, is measured against the incident ray. So that's why we have taken here negative. Further, the image for the eye lens is found at the least distance of distinct vision. This is the least distance of distinct vision. We have already denoted it as by capital D, and is measured against the incident ray. So we will put the value. We got, after multiplying the above equation by capital D, we got D by U minus 1, because D by D will becomes equal to 1 here multiplied by D. So we got D by U is equals to D by F in this way. Rearranging this equation, we got D by U is equals to 1 plus D by FE, and here we have this U is equals to UE. So this D by UE is basically magnification produced by the eye lens. So M is equal to 1 plus D by FE. Now, using the values from equation number 4, that is the value of M0 and value of ME, ME obtained from equation number 5, we will put its value in this equation number 3. So we got this relation, which is the required expression. And if we consider that this object U0 is lying at approximately equals to F0, if U0 is lying at a near approximate distance, that is equals to F0, then V0 will be equals to this V0, image distance. This will lie very near to this eye lens because it has a short focal length. So image found by the object lens will lie very close to it, such that this distance will be equals to V0 will be equals to F. Putting the value, we got this derivation. So here one thing should be noted, that magnification is coming out to be negative. In simple microscope, the net magnification produced was positive. Positive means virtual enlarged magnified image was produced on the same side of the object. But here in this case, we are getting here negative sign. What does it mean? Final image produced by the
compound microscope is the real end of inverter. The second thing here, if we look about this expression, then magnification produced by this compound microscope is inversely proportional to the focal length, inversely proportional to the focal length of the objective as well as focal length of the eye lens. So both, in order to produce a greater magnification, we must have the objective as well as eyepiece, they must have the short focal length. Only under that condition the greater magnification will be produced. So this is the required expression. This was the first case when magnifying, when the image is formed at the least distance of testing tuition. Now the second case is there, that is when the image is formed at infinity. So when the image is formed at infinity, then what would happen? Simply we will write m is equals to m naught into me, where m naught is equals to v naught by minus u naught, and what about me? That will be equals to d by fe. So in that case, how we can derive this expression? When image is formed at infinity, when the image is formed at infinity, under that condition we got the formula, that is net magnification produced by the compound microscope is given by m naught into me. So putting the value here, what about m naught? Here I will write, let it be question number 1. Here m naught is equals to V naught by minus U naught, okay, and this ME, magnification produced by the eye lens, that will be equals to D by F. Okay, so therefore from equation 1 we got the net magnification produced is equals to minus V naught by U naught multiplied by D by Fe, and if U naught is approximately equals to F naught, if U naught is, that is object distance is approximately equal to F naught, then V naught will be approximately equals to F. So then this formula will becomes M is equals to minus of L by F naught into D by Fe. So in this way, the net magnification produced by the compound microscope when the image is formed at infinity, because still here the all the steps will remain same. This is exercise 9.27 of new NCERT textbook, and in old NCERT textbook this exercise is 9.32. The question is, an angular magnification or magnifying power of 30x is desired. So we have given here the angular magnification, that is total m is equals to 30x is desired. Using an objective of focal length, this 1.25 centimeter, and eyepiece of focal length FE is equals to 5 centimeter. The question is, how will you set up this compound microscope? Need to say, we want to set up this compound microscope. So setup means, what should be the distance between the object lens and the eye lens? Means to say, we want to calculate this L. And what about this L? In order to find this L, we have to calculate this V naught and we have to calculate this UV.
So this is the demand of the question. So let's start solving it. So here in this case, as the net magnification is given to us, we have given the FE. So as we know that the magnification produced by this lens, when the image is formed at the least distance of distinct vision. So here I am writing, as we know that net magnification is equals to product of M naught and ME. Let it be equation number one. Since the image is formed at the least distance of distinct vision, so D can be taken as 25 centimeter. So here, further, as we have given, further as ME, magnification produced by the lens is given by 1 plus D over FE. Okay, so what about this D? D is equals to 25 centimeter. What about the focal length of eye lens? That is equals to 5 centimeter. So they both will get cancelled out. 5 5 25, or magnification produced by the eye lens is 6. We got the value. Now, as from equation 1, if we put the value of this ME and if we put the value of M, that is the desired magnifying power, we got the value of magnification produced by the object lens. So therefore, from equation 1, what we get, M value is 30. Putting the value, M naught still remain it is as it is. What about ME? That is 6, which implies M naught is equals to 30 by 6, or M naught is equals to 5. Or in the next step, we can write this M naught as the magnification produced by the object lens is negative. So M naught is equals to V naught by U naught, and we can find the V naught on the same bit. So here I am writing, since V naught is equals to, since M naught is equals to, M naught is equals to V naught by U naught, and which implies this is equals to minus 5 is equals to V naught by U naught. Putting the value, which implies V naught is equals to minus of 5 U naught. Let this be equation number 2. Now, in order to calculate this what we can say V naught, we will make use of Lenz equation. As we note that minus of 1 by U naught plus 1 by V naught is equals to 1 by F naught. It is given to us, F naught is given to us. We will put the respective values. So what about this U naught? What about this V naught? If we put eliminate this V naught, we get minus 1 by U naught plus 1 over minus 5 U naught is equals to 1 by F naught, which further implies minus 5 here in this case, and here minus 1 over 5 U naught is equals to 1 over F naught is given 1.25 centimeter. So which implies minus 6 by 5 U naught is equals to 100 over 125. So here we got, if we divide it by what we can say, 25, so 425 is 100 and 525 is 125, and such that this 5 and 5 will get cancelled out, further 5 and 5 will get cancelled out. So we got in the next step minus 6 by U naught is equals to 4, or U naught is equals to minus 6 over 4, that is equals to minus 3 by 2, or U naught is equals to minus 1.5 centimeter. So this is the object distance. So if we put about this value in the equation number 2, so in the next step I will write, therefore from equation 2, what we get, we got the V naught. V naught is equals to minus 5 multiplied by U naught, minus 1.5 centimeter, we got 7.5 centimeter. So our first aim has been fulfilled, that we have calculated the value of this V naught. Now we want to calculate this UE, that is the object distance for the I length. So as we know that, in order to calculate this UE, what the condition we will make use? We have given the value of this FE. Now ME, what about ME? ME, we know about ME, that is equals to 6. ME is equals to VE over UE. So what about the image? Image is formed at the least distance of this equation. So now, as we know that magnification produced by the eye length is equals to VE over UE. Okay, so if we put the value, that is ME is equals to 6, VE is equals to D, because image is formed at the least distance of distinct vision. So here I am writing minus D over this UE, or we can write UE is equals to minus of 25 centimeter over 6. Okay, so dividing this by 6, what we get, UE is equals to minus 4.6, 4 the 24, 1 will carry 6, 1 the 6, then 4 will carry 6, 6 the, so 4.17, this will be the object distance for the eye length. So we got the value of this UE, we got the value of this V naught. So we want to calculate L, and what about the value of L? So setup, if we got the value of L, then we got the setup of the compound microscope. So further, or since L is equals to mod of V naught plus mod of UE. So put the values, V naught is equals to 7.5 centimeter and UE is equals to 4.1 centimeter. We got the value, that is equals to 7, 5 and 1, 6 and 11.67. This is the setup required in order to produce this 30x magnifying power by the compound microscope. Again, I am explaining, magnifying power or angular magnification of 30x is desired from the compound microscope, for which the image is found at the least distance of distinct vision, and we are provided with the focal length of the object lens, we are provided with the focal length of eye lens. So both that, what is the setup? Setup, how will you set up this compound microscope? So first of all, we have made use of the formula that net magnification produced by the compound microscope is given by M is equals to product of the magnification produced by object lens and eye lens. Further, as magnification produced by the eye lens is given by 1 plus D by FE, and that is found to be 6, because the image is found at the least distance of distinct vision, it is given to us. So therefore, putting it value in equation 1, we got the value of magnification produced by the object, that is equals to 5. Okay, in the next step, M naught is equal to V naught by U naught. So putting the value of this, because magnification produced by this object lens is negative, because the real image is formed by the object lens. This is the basic trick here for solving this numerical. We put the value minus V, and we got V naught is equals to minus U naught. Now using the lens equation, putting the value of this V naught, eliminating V naught in terms and expressing it in terms of U naught, we got the value U naught is equals to minus 1.5 centimeter in this way. Okay, we got the value of U naught, then we can get the value of V naught. Putting the value here, we will got the V naught. So first primary target has been achieved, that is we have calculated the image distance formed by the object lens, that is 7.5 centimeter. Now as magnification produced by the eye lens is given by VE by UE, so since VE is the image distance for the compound microscope and the image is found at the least distance of distinct vision, that is minus D, so UE is equals to minus 25 by 6 centimeter. So UE is equals to comes out to be minus 4.17 centimeter. So So for setting up of the operators, we have to use this value of L. L is equals to basically sum of the object distance and the image distance produced by the object lens and the object distance for the eye lens. So in this way we got the value of 11.67 centimeter. That is the distance between the object lens and the eye lens should be 11.67 centimeter. So this was all our today's lecture. Thank you, students.